That's a great photograph, and these are actually some of these are the photographs we were able to take out of Cuba eventually slowly, because he had, I mean, so many photographs, but we were only able to recover about 120 after.
How were you able to go into Cuba and get the photograph?
Oh, clandestine. No,
basically. I'm not calling them, but.
No, at some point the family started gathering some of the photographs that they had.
Hemingway's family?
No, my family. And they would send a letter, but probably put it between something, you know, make sure it was like a package that was flat. And you run the risk of that envelope being open.
But you did not go to Cuba and get it.
No, in 1986, I brought back only 7. But most of the other 20 came via mail, yeah. Now, this is the cover. That's my mom, that's my dad. And this is 1957. And it's really funny because I heard this story so many times, and this is a great photograph that they still have in their living room. Hemingway actually has shorts on, because it's a little cool that in March. And he told Mary to photograph them from the waist up. So he has a sweater because it's really cool. And he's telling my mom, take good care of my Cuban son. This is a week before they got married. And it's so interesting, this is 1957, and 50 years later, I'll show you a photograph, which is great because I wanted to take a photograph of my parents. I'll show you the photograph. Hemingway dies in 1961 by his own hand. And a week before that happened, my father actually received the letter from Ernest Hemingway. And after my father read the letter, and a week later after Hemingway committed suicide, then he realizes that in the letter, Hemingway's telling him goodbye. And take care of my finca, take care of my cats. And that's also a very important letter that got lost in Cuba with the other photographs. And he actually had also one manuscript that had given my father to hide in the house and only give to Mary personally when she came to Cuba. So he actually, we don't know what manuscript it was, but he actually had a very extensive manuscript that Papa gave him before he left Cuba. Okay, and fast forwarding to this photograph, in 1961, Hemingway commits suicide, Mary goes to Cuba, and she makes a deal with Fidel Castro to take her belongings out of the finca, whatever she wants to. There's the one Greece painting worth a lot of money. Thankfully, the Joan Miró painting, the farm, had been taken out of Cuba in 1957 and went to the Museum of Modern Art. So in a way, she's trying to work with Castro to see if she can take all her expensive belongings and the paintings and the manuscripts and everything, and they come to an agreement that she donates the finca to the Cuban people, and she wanted to make sure it was to the Cuban people, not the Cuban government, to the Cuban people. And then Castro allows her to take her belongings out. My father leaves the finca. This is the first time in 21 years he's been out of the finca. But a year later, Fidel Castro looks for him because he wants him back to restore the house because it had gone to shambles. So he becomes the first director administrator of the Hemingway Museum, and he restores the finca back to its former glory. And he has that job for 6 years before we leave the country. And my father, and it's interesting, in my family, my father's side, and I know this to be true, especially my father was apolitical. He didn't belong to any party in Cuba. And for him to have that kind of job was the only reason was because Castro gave him the job. Then no one could fire him. But no one wanted to work with him because he didn't belong to any party. And he was not affiliated with the Communist Party. And so he was basically doing the job that he was doing for Hemingway of maintaining the house and bringing it to the museum. And once he realized that it would stay in the museum and it was not going to be destroyed again, that's when he realized they went to leave the country.
Do you know if to this day the finca is still a museum in Cuba?
Yes, it is. As a matter of fact, it has been a museum since it opened in 1964 was the official, I'm sorry, 1962 was the official date. It has been a museum ever since, and it just underwent incredible restorations in the last 2 years. And it's looking, I think, better than ever. La finca ahora se ve, la atracción se ve magnífica, ¿verdad?
Sí, muy bien.
And also, in 2007, my father's room was inaugurated and opened to the public. It became part of the museum tour.
Are those people Americans in that picture?
No, very good question. This is, of course, 1965. Czechoslovakian, Romanian, Russian delegations, and they came by the trunk busloads. It was such, and still is one of the most visited museums in Havana. Es una delegación de Checoslovaquia. They, and basically they loved Hemingway, and anything he had to say about Hemingway, they just were hanging on every word that he told them about Hemingway. Still a museum director. This is Hemingway's study, by the way, adjacent to the workroom. And this is the buffalo, and it's explained also in the book. This is the buffalo that's described in The Short Happy Life of Francis Macumber. That's the buffalo that the events that took place, that's the actual, and that's the actual rifle too right here. Este es el rifle que usaba.
Yeah, este buffalo matado en el año
34. In 1934. So with his second wife, Pauline,
1934.
La Verde Colina, o la Corta Vida de Mr. Macumber, ¿cuál de los dos?
Bueno, sí, es la...
Porque
la Verde Colina de África es Kunuk que tiene todo. Y esta es la Vía Corta de Mr. Macumber.
He actually was correcting me that he thought it was in the Greenhouse of Africa, but he remembers now that Kudu is the one from the Greenhouse of Africa. This is from The Short Happy Life of Mr. Macumber. Here, the Villarreal family in Spain. We left Cuba in 1972, and by that time my father had resigned from the position of the museum in 1968, and he was sent to the sugarcane fields for 2 years, and basically pay his due to the country to be able to leave the island. And here we're in Madrid, happy family, wife and five kids. And that's right in Madrid. And this is actually for a magazine in Spain to interview him, because they welcome the magazine. Actually, the headlines was welcoming Hemingway's Cuban son into Spain. Yeah, that's me.
You're so cute.
I had hair back then. I wasn't born like this.
Not anymore.
And now, this is also, so you can visualize, this is the entrance to the finca over here. This is the big gate. But from here to the finca, ¿cuánto tú crees que media milla para caminar de la casa? It's about, from here up to the house is a little steep road about half a mile long. This is where they were playing baseball, the kids.
Aquí.
And that's where my father lived. Right here is the house. Right here, that's where we're playing, and that's where that's the dandruff.
Like
right after school, is it? And so here's my father, and that's his twin brother. You can see they're still kind of dressed alike. That was in 1996 when we went back to get the manuscript and the photographs, but they were lost.